with y'all. We're sitting here officially in the workout area where we're filming the dedication. So as we promised, you know what I'm saying, it's coming to y'all this Monday. We just got done working on triceps and then back. But it's only us two here today. Kiara is off doing her.
She actually at school.
Oh, she is?
Yeah.
See, what we do, we taking our time out of our day to come talk to y'all who we should be at practice.
But we love y'all.
Yeah,
so,
yeah.
It's okay. We love y'all.
Shout out, amen. Yeah. All right, so, you know, in the wrestling world, you know, a lot of things that I think is wrong with it is there's no backstory in the characters that y'all see. Y'all have no, like, connection to them. So what we want to bring y'all is give y'all a connection to us. So today, in episode 6 of Life of a Wrestler, we're going to be interviewing my five.
Owen Knight.
Hey, what's up, John? All right, so basically what we're going to do is a little short Q&A. Got 10 questions for him. And
if there's any questions, which we're not going to spend an hour on this, because we were told of some comments that we ramble on incoherently. So, as long as we get a view, that's really that. So, if you guys have any questions or anything or any suggestions on what you should do, comment below.
Alright, so let's get into this. We got 10 questions. So the first question I got for you five is, your name is Owen Knight. Where did this name come from?
One day me and my aunt were watching the stories. He was watching the stories, the soap opera. And it was a guy, well, first of all, my original last name is Owens. So I took my S off my last name, which is made Owens. My Knight name came from my great grandmother, which is Nick Knight, MC. You see the MC off the main Owen Knight. But before all that transpired, it was a soap opera story. I'm not pretty sure what the soap opera was, but my aunt has long used that name. And I was like, well, his name's already taken. But that soap opera doesn't come on anymore. We twist and turns and everything, came up with Owen Knight. My original name was Amputator. It was going to be Amputator.
All right, so speaking of that, you know, I got to say the problems every now and then. Wrestling is not very, you know, sometimes everybody be like, good, you're going to be a professional wrestler? Really? You know how hard that is? What is your favorite thing about you coming down here to Georgia? Moving where you're from. We'll get to that later, ladies and gentlemen. Moving from where you're from, coming down here, basically starting over fresh and joining a professional wrestling.
Well, I mean, of course, when you're the oldest, leaving the house, it's hard. It's hard because, you know, your mom or your dad, whoever's in your life, your mom, aunt, grandmother, they had that sense of fear that you're going to be like given to the wolves, so to speak. So my mom was against it. In 2011, me, my aunt, and my formal tag partner at the time came down here to visit the school, but we didn't tell my mom anything about it. So when my mom finally came down here once I graduated, she said, and I quote, "It's like I'm leading you to the wolves," and she started crying. So my mom was against it. My aunt, she wanted me to go out and succeed. She wanted me to, and not saying my mom didn't either, but my aunt knew that she couldn't hold me in captivity for long. So she wanted me to go out, and from there to now, I feel like it kind of worked. So love you, mom.
So do you think that she has come more into fruition and liking what you're doing?
My mom learns. She's learning to like put up with it, so to speak. You know, because you know, when you're your mama's first child, of course she wanted me to actually play basketball.
I feel like it's hard to play basketball.
When you're not talented with the ball, it's just gonna be crazy. So yeah, that's how that happened. But right now, we're in a good place right now, so.
Okay. And so everybody has that moment where you sit there, you watch a wrestler, and it's like, bam, that's what I want to do. So as a child coming up, when and where, what time, how did you know that that's what you wanted to do? Childhood experience.
My first match, I saw, it wasn't at that time, but the first match I actually saw was Bret. I know it's cliche, but it was Bret Hart and Shawn Michaels at WrestleMania. I know that's cliche, but it's just at the time I didn't really know what storytelling was and what magic wrestling as a whole could be. And watching them and the way the crowd would react and the way that they would put them all their body on the line for a title, for a belt. And not to mention 60 minutes. So at that particular time where when they did it, that was unheard of. Like, who can wrestle for 60 minutes at that time? So it was, I mean, yeah, but now the times have changed. But at that time it was cool and it was something new. I never wanted to be mediocre with my career choice. Like, I didn't want to be like, oh, I'm a firefighter, or I'm a cop, or I'm a rapper. I didn't want to be mediocre. Like, I wanted to, someone asked me, I wanted to wrestle. And it was kind of, that's what it was. That's where it was. Watching that and watching Raw and Spike, when it was on Spike, and watching SmackDown when it was Bridget on Thursdays, it just wanted me to feel it.
So, all right. This whole thing, the big picture is professional wrestling. So, you're very passionate about where you're from. What is wrestling, professional wrestling, sports entertainment, whatever you choose to call it, whatever y'all choose to call it, what does professional wrestling slash entertainment mean to you?
First, wrestling, for years, wrestling was like, it is and kind of still is. I mean, so was, it kind of still is, taken as a joke. No, a lot of people think professional wrestling is like a smoke in the mirror. It's like, if anyone can do it. But until you step into the business and you step into a ring, you actually, like when I first started, before I even started watching on TV, I always thought I could do it. I was like, oh, this is easy. But once I finally, the first day I got here, I'm like, do I really want to do this? Like, do I really want to do this before my life? But understanding the business and having a passion for it, it's time for a change. I feel as though on TV nowadays you get the same stuff that happens over and over and over again. No offense to anyone, but you had, you know, old timers, the legends would come back and just do the same regurgitated stuff. And I feel as though management and higher people try to play us like we're stupid. They don't try to, they don't think their audience is intelligent enough to know what stuff doesn't look like, what stuff doesn't seem like, or just weird, just crazy. And the spoilers and everything, it's so hard to just keep it into one. But for me, wrestling is just an out-of-body experience. It's an open story with endless possibilities.
All right, so outside of wrestling, inside of wrestling, I'm talking about behind the scenes, the new
to
guys.
To the new guys is just, if this is what you breathe and this is what you want to do with your life, then make it your life. Find something that motivates you to go do it. If your mom has cancer, your brother is retarded, and then if you want to make enough money to take care of them and to make sure their lives are, you know, secure, then that's your motivation. You want to get your mom out of the hood, like your mom in the crib, that's your motivation. Find something that motivates you. You just wanted to do in there to just have money and bang a lot of chicks. If that's your motivation, then do that, because know what you're doing and why you're doing it. Don't just put on boots or kick pads and be like, don't do that. Nobody knows you're doing like that. That's all it is.
All right, so you just touched on that. We got two questions left.
Right. I hope this is it. 15 minutes.
It's probably going
to be. Oh,
it's okay, because we're going in depth.
Oh, Lord.
All right, I'm about to say that. Two questions left. All right, so you touched on it right then and there, and you were about to, but you stopped so we can continue on with the current questions. So what is next for On Night in the future, 2015?
Tweak some of the stuff that, you know, that's going to reoccur in me in the future, even though all of it might not, but the majority of what I want to learn will. As far as the wrestling wise, I'm going to do more indies. I want to travel to different other states to visit the schools. Go to Detroit, New Orleans, go to the West Coast just to get other people's opinions, the Team 3D school. I want to go there just to get my name out, just let them know that it is good people that actually can wrestle out here. And we're not just doing a lot of spots. You see what I'm saying? That actually could work and actually could do this. So, yeah, that's pretty much my plan.
All right, Bob, so this is our last question. I appreciate you. Thank you.
Thanks for having me.
thank you guys for watching. The last question is, what does Owen Knight see in the future for himself in the world of professional wrestling?
I see me making it. You know, my mama always said that you got it. If you can envision it, my mama, if you can envision it, you can achieve it. If you have it, if you have it fans about it, then it, you gotta kind of pick and choose. Like, if Monday you win it and Tuesday you not, then it's not for you. Like, my trainer Hugh says, you don't have confidence, you can't do this. You have to have confidence. And at this point, I'm confident in my ability. So I can step into the ring and work with anybody. I just have to believe in myself, which I've done since day one. So, I'm going up from here. Not just on Tuesday. I'm going up further and further and further. And I see myself make it. I see my five make it. I see the first lady make it. Because once we're on, we all on. So, that's just all I can say. The possibilities are endless. The possibilities are endless. I feel special. This is my first day that
that's it.
I feel like I made it, bro.
Very good. All right, so that's all 10 questions. Once again, we're going to plug this for the third time here. We are in the dedication. This is where we film it. We have got the third day filmed. The other 2 days are already done. So we'll be doing drop Monday, whatever date it is. You know we bad at dates, we bad at being on time. Right. It might just be because we black, but you never know.
My skin out or something, I don't even know.
So, you know, like, share, subscribe, follow.
Snapchat, everything.
Everywhere.
I know you're going to plug the Instagram stuff on your page. I ain't going to say this. But if you don't,
this is all about you. Instagram. This was all about you.
Oh, okay. Right. Thank you. I feel special. Thank you.
All right, well, thank you for watching. We're going to catch you next time on episode.